Oh, an email. That's pretty cool. Hello, YouTube, and welcome back to... Guess what? Guess what this is? Guess it. Another episode of... Oh, it's not too hard. Oh, I'm sure you can find what this is, what game this is. LS Ocean 1, yes, indeed. We are back here into the Sea of Manaurai to explore the wonderful ocean and all its creatures once again. Last episode, we explored some around Deep Valley over here. We did a couple squares of the map, and we uncovered some area, found new fish and everything, and that was pretty cool. We found a lot of things in this area, and we had Catherine talk to us about the Mermaid's Grotto. I hope that's what it's called in this version of the game. This area over here that we have the red X at, apparently it's a system of underwater caves that are made of limestone and that are supposedly coinciding with some parts of a legend saying there is a cave where a mermaid flew. Well, not flew, but swam into it to run away from a catastrophe in her kingdom, and she hid into a cave that was made of limestone, a white cave. And apparently there are not necessarily white, but limestone caves into this area over here. So today we're going to go and investigate that. And also let's check the email we got. Smart Look Monthly. Greetings from Alfred Tolman. Smart Look Monthly, the magazine you subscribed to. I didn't know I subscribed to a magazine. I didn't know it was subscribed to anything. Has been delivered to our offices. Please find it attached. Okay. New item. Long blonde style. Oh. That was just to give us... Oh. Okay, I get it. Oh, that was just... Oh, that's cool. Okay, so we got a new hairstyle. Let's check this out. Blah. I can't speak today. So we got normal blonde style, and I think this way we'll get long blonde style. I'm pretty sure I prefer the other. Pretty sure I prefer that one than this one. That looks way too pale. I look like... let me think. What character am I... I look like Sephiroth, that's what I'm thinking about here. Although I never played Final Fantasy VII, I saw pictures of that guy, and that's what this makes me think of. Although this is like grayish, but it's darker. And I think this looks better, because that's like, the hair is almost paler than my skin. It doesn't work. I think we're just gonna keep on going with this for now. And anyways, let's check what we have on the boat, and then I think we'll move to the X on the map. Do we have anything interesting on the boat? Nothing. Not a fish. Or not a creature, not a mammal, because we don't have fish on the boat, usually, well, ever. We have birds and we have mammals, so no mammal or bird on the boat at the moment. Let's go move the boat to can we dive? I don't want to dive too close of it. As usual, I want to get closer as I'm diving to make it interesting. Okay, let's go diving with Espoir, because why not? He could probably show us some zooms. And let's use the regular music. In case you don't know, this slider here, this is to choose your music when you're gonna dive. We don't have many, and also it will repeat the same music every single time that the music ends when you dive. So if you choose a song that you like, you're gonna like it, but you're going to hear it 25 times while you're diving. So because of that, we're not gonna put any music. Already I can see something here. We have leopard whale prey. There we go. Let's pet this guy. We got the second information on it. Pretty cool. What else do we have here? Let's look at the map where we are. We're going the wrong way. Obviously, because that's totally something I would do. Oh, hello. Oh, Espoir found something. What is it? And I see a hammerhead. We can check that after. Ooh la la. This is new stuff. A lot of new fish. This is Harlequin Sweet Lips, young one. We don't find any adults of this in the whole game. This is Emperor Angelfish, a young. But the other fish that just swam away from my screen, that's a new one too. If you can come back, please. Yes. Hello. Ah. My controls are going everywhere. Click the wrong place. There we go. Royal Angelfish. And this can be found, can be seen in the coral in all areas of Manaurai all year round. As I already told earlier in the series, the zooms are so incredibly hard to find in this compared to like the fish like you're gonna find just in the main water, that those are always the last fish in the game that I have to make a 3 out of 3s in. And also, I think in the caves area, there are some of the rarest fish in the game. Actually, not yet, but it's going to be soon into areas where we can find rarest fish, because the rarest fish areas are all found, the rarest fish are all found in secret areas, and the caves are one of those secret areas, although it's not the right one. These are a different type of ray. These are the red stingray. Spread it. I think this is the third time. Nope, second time. Huh, we'll have to visit it another time in the future. And apart from those, do I have any fish here that I missed? Oh, there's a turtle. Hello. The turtle is going into the cave. Hello. Oh, we only found it one time? Are you serious? I always thought we found it two times at least. There we go, second time. I know we found it the first time. It was at the lagoon at night, pretty sure. That was when it was going there to lay the eggs that it has, even though it never actually does that. But I think that's the logic for it being found there. That's a cave. That's definitely a cave. And we're right on the X. So, we're told to find limestone caves. This is apparently limestone, even though it looks exactly like every single rock in the game. So, let's go. You know, there's a chance that this cave is the mermaid's grotto that Douglas mentioned. No, it's the only cave that you can find in this game. Of course it is. Let's take a look inside. Who knows what we might find? Oh yeah, adventure! And we discovered our first off-map area, the Great Aqua Cave. My diver is diving very interestingly. A sea cave that resembles a white palace, fit for a mermaid princess. Ooh la la. Wow, that's definitely what I have to say. I am so happy to see that cutscene again. That's the second time I played this game, and the only second time that I've seen this cutscene by playing myself. And it's, oh, I just remember the first time I played this game. So magical. And my dolphin is already screaming at me for a zoom. Let me first see what Catherine has to say. Wow, I don't know what to say. I never thought I'd see anywhere like this in Manaurai. Espoir, shut up! I mean, a limestone cave as large as this isn't something you get to see every day. Let's see what we can find in here. The interior looks fairly complex. Take care to not lose your bearings. Bearings? Well, you say bear, and you say ring, so bearing. Although my intuition tells me it would be bearings for some reason. I don't know, I think because you say earrings, but you say bear.
Bearings. Let's go with bearings. Take care not to lose your bearings. Okay, we can explore this cave. And what I meant by saying it's off map is this.
This is a new map. This is not in the main sea. We got, in a way, teleported to a different sea. Well, in the game's code, this is an off-map area that is invisible from the main map. It doesn't even exist in the main ocean. And if we go in there, it's going... Espoir, you know what? I'm really gonna check what you want to show me. I hope it's worth it. And I think it is. Oh yeah, it is. But you were being really noisy. You could have waited a little bit. Monster Shrimp Gobby. This can be seen on the sandy floor in all areas of Manaurai all year round. I was hoping we would find cave-related species, because I know you can find gobies and shrimp that are only found in underwater caves in this area somewhere. Can be seen in all areas of Manaurai on the sandy ocean floor all year round. So these fish are, like, not special from the cave at all. These can be found anywhere. We just happened to find them here. Espoir, if you... I was gonna say, if you scream at me once last time, I'm going to, but... I don't even know what I'm going to do. I can't do anything. You're too cute. So, just please don't do too much noise. Let's check some of these fish. These are new. In French, they're called Saint-Pierre. In English, I have no idea. In English, they're called John Dory. Completely different. Thought it would maybe be Saint-Pierre or something like that, but nope. John Dory. In French, the name Saint-Pierre comes from the fact that it is said from a legend that the oval mark on the fish right there you see on the side has been created by the thumb of a saint named Pierre. That's why it's called that in French. In English, I don't know why it's called John Dory at all. These, it tends to lurk in underwater caves where it can be seen all year round. Again, I'm just going to repeat this. Do not take this information as credibility in real life because all of these fish locations or distribution have been made up for this game. So there are fish that will say, oh my gosh, Espoir, what do you want to show me now? Oh, it's a drop, it's not a drop, it's a zoom. I would like to have a mute button for you sometime. And of course it's like two fish that you find everywhere. Although this, we never found this save. Oh no, we didn't. This is a fish I find the most commonly, like I found this all the time on the seafloor. I don't even have to look for it usually. This is a stray-headed frogfish. And this is, from experience, the most common fish I'll find in zooms in the game. Except the Starkstorm ones. That one is pretty common, too. This is a fish we found in the lagoon at night, too. And this is said when we found it in the lagoon that can be seen mostly around the Nice Reef during the spring. And this is another off-season location for it in the underwater cave. And that one we got another info on it. What else is there here? I saw another fish I wanted to check out. Oh my gosh, is that the same zoom? Where are you? Oh, hello. This is not the same zoom. Oh. Okay, thank you. Earthenware piece. Thank you for that. You were actually being useful. Let's go to another room of this place. Actually, let's look at this window first. I believe you can... Yeah, you can click on it. You can see the other side. Seems to be a narrow passageway. We cannot access to it yet. And we can't swim through this. This is way too tiny. Even though, it looks like we could squeeze through. In real life, one of the risks in underwater diving is when you go into small or narrow passageways, because if you hit your oxygen bottle on the ceiling and it has like a crack into it, then all your oxygen is going to go into water and you're gonna die of suffocation. So, that is one of the main dangers in underwater diving in real life. It seems to be only one way we can get out of this room, and that is this way. Yep, I saw the tunnel. Let's go straight into that. To this creepy little passageway that goes
into darkness. Although it's never completely dark in this area, the lighting seems to be a little bit eerie, I find, because even though here it should be entirely dark because there is nothing, no light at all, there is no access to sunlight here, it isn't. And I believe the clown triggerfish, right here, those are not found three times. Oh yeah, they are. Interesting, I didn't think they were. This is certainly new. Blue-spotted ribbon-tail ray. It tends to lurk in underwater caves where it can be seen all year round. In the Po Republic, it has a name meaning green light. Interesting. The legend says that these fish were what guided some poor adventurers out of the underwater caves when they got lost. They would follow the green light, it was said. And these fish have a Powell name for green light. So this is probably the mysterious green light that the travelers were following when exploring these caves. And that's how they got out, because you can find them everywhere. Stalactite maze. Oh, I hate this place. Well, I love it, it's cool and all, but you know, mazes and me, they don't go well together. At all. I got lost into this maze so many times. And they didn't play this or like come into this in a long time. Let me see if I can remember my way through this. You go in here, and then you go down here. And up. And then, where are we now? I'm trying to get to one of the exits of this place. There's another tunnel here. You can go into this. Following the green light. And up. To this room here. And what is here? Two passageways out of this room. Where will we go? Is one of them a dead end? Nope, both of them lead to the same place, although one is longer. I think we're gonna take the shorter way, because we don't have infinite time of this episode, and I want to get as much exploration as I can done without rushing too much, because I love taking my time in this too. Oh, this is an off-season fish, definitely. These are groupers, I think? Mignata grouper, yeah. And these can be seen in all areas of Manaurai, mainly in the autumn. Or fall, if you prefer. And in off-season, you can find them here all year. Let me see what zoom is here. These fish, the yellow long-nosed butterfly fish, and another piece of... Oh, I'm petting it. What an idiot. Earthenware piece, there we go. I think at the end, if we find all the pieces, we're going to assemble something when we come back to the boat. To find more, though. Oh, hello. Ah, Harlequin Sweet Lips. We found them earlier, though. They're way more common in the cave, and it's ironic enough because we found them outside of the cave first. In my first save game, that was not the case. I found them in the cave first, and that's where I got all my other info on them because they're fairly common on the seafloor. Actually, we should look for zooms on the seafloor as we go. Hey, green light! Oh. That is another fish here. Ooh, I hear interesting sounds. That is... Oh, I know what that is. Hey, attractive grabbit. Flathead. This is found... Can easily be seen during the winter in the Blue Hall area. Blue Hall. Oh, a zoom. Hello. Another one of the frogfish, another harlequin sweet lips. Nope. Not going to pay attention to that at the moment. Pyramid fish on the ceiling. Are those a two? No, there are three already. That goes back to the maze. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna go this way. This cave is so massive that I think it's going to require us at least two different episodes to do the entirety of this. I'll show you why in a second after I get the zoom. This is three spot Dasilus. Oh, we can get the third time on this. And I believe this is a new fish. Yep.
Threadfin butterfly fish. And I'm not going to look at that because I already know what it's going to say. It's going to say it can be found in coral all year round, as it does usually. But yeah, on the map, let me show you what I'm talking about here. Oh, I'm going the wrong way. I'm going the stupid wrong way. I'm supposed to go that way. Because there are two different like main areas in this cave. When you go into this, the labyrinth branches off to these two rooms on this side and these two rooms on that side. So you can decide if you want to take that path or the other. And this time I'm going to take this one, and the next episode we're probably going to do to go straight that way and then up and skip the labyrinth completely, because that place is just to explore. Peaceful music, lovely. Let's go that way and up. Actually, now that I'm thinking of it, it looks like there are sunlight axes. Although, I don't see any holes into the ceiling, so I don't know how sunlight will be able to come down here. Let's just call it video game logic. Because that's what it is. Another flathead. Another one of those spots. Actually, this is probably the same. This is the same area I was into. And this is the way to go to another room. Cascade pool. And there are manatees. That is what doing the little whistling noise, if I can call it that, is these guys. I believe it's manatees anyways. Might be wrong. Yeah, West Indian manatee. And he just did a 360. I believe that in real life, there are some people who can dive with those. Although they are very, I was not going to say dangerous, but they are very close to be extinct. They're not dangerous at all, I don't think. They're just eating plants on the bottom of the water. And they see another one of those zooms into this crevice. Another piece of the, petting it again. Earthenware piece, there we go. Let's get that. And let's see if we can find anything on these stairs, because I know that this place is the best place to find gobies in the whole game. Like, not the gobies that you find in the Den of Spirits, not those ones in the coral branches. The one that lives in two holes in the sand, accompanied with their shrimp. Those are so common. Yep, look, we already found one. And these are specific to caves, I think. Not the shrimp. But the goby is, pretty sure. Oh no, that can be found everywhere. This is probably a unique to... I believe he doesn't like to be pet. I think we have to feed him. Yeah, we have to feed him, probably. Eat. Eat again. Oh, there we go. Goby shrimp. And this can be found in underwater caves. There we go. And ocean floor areas all year round. Let me see if I can find some more of the gobies on these stairs. Also, you guys have to tell me, do you want me to do some commentary that doesn't have to do with the game when I play this? It has been an idea I've thought of doing, and I think that frogfish has just been pushed by that little Chromis. I might be wrong though, that was pretty funny. Let's see it again. He's just walking and, oh, it's random how it does it. I don't think we're gonna get that to happen again. Yeah, it's random, never mind. But I wanted to ask, what do you guys want to see as commentary into the series? Because if you remember, some of you probably remember, my Grassy Wednesdays series, I did, not too long ago, I finished it. It was a little podcasty series I was doing
in Minecraft while removing some mycelium and placing some grass into my Minecraft Let's Play series. And I thought this series might be the new podcast series. We could do a same kind of thing in this series, do some kind of podcast while we're diving. But at the same time, I have a lot of things to say about the game itself that I don't know if we have time or if we can fit into this some commentary of like other things. But you guys can tell me if you want to. I think later in the series, when we're going to be like finding some fisher things, or when we're going to be examining the ocean floor in areas we already explored to find some specific fish together three times, that'll be some good times that we could do some commentary of other things. Although right now we're still like in the beginning of this, and we're discovering something every single episode. So, are you kidding me? I just zoomed. There's nothing! Oh. Okay, there's a fish. I did not expect that, to see just like a hole and like no fish at all. That's pretty cool still, I guess. Clown trigger fish young. We already found those like everywhere. Getting pretty close to the waterfall. Oh, another zoom. Ah, another one of those. Nothing to see there. Another zoom here. Aha! Monster shrimp goby. We have only one on that. Let's get a second visit. Am I being stupid? I think I'm being stupid. I think I already got that one. Just for the first time in the same dive. Whoops. Derpy MDB. I'm not ashamed of my derpiness. Let's go into the back of the waterfall here. This is why it's called the waterfall cascade, I think is what it's called, because there's a waterfall under the water, which is quite unusual. But the thing is, the waterfall isn't really underwater. It's actually right here. As you can see, the graphics are so good. Look at this realisticness. Although it's not really made to be seen from this angle, the game really made it so you could see it from underwater, because here it looks, where is it? Here it is. Yeah, it looks a lot better when you see it underwater. You don't see like that jitteriness. Let's go behind the waterfall into the last room that we're going to see into this dive. I think we can see the main room from this. This is the other side of the window we saw into earlier. Yeah, this is exactly the other side to that. You've entered into what looks like a large hall. That's a weird message for this. Because I did not enter into it. I look into it. That seems like a message that should have been used when I entered the hall at the other side of this. I don't know what to think about that. Oh, white. Whiteness. The legendary white room. We found it. This is the white room that legend talks about. Where the mermaid hid. Ah, oh, this is a beautiful place. This is one of my favorite areas in the game, probably. In my first dive, in my first save game in this cave, I did not go into this area first. I went into that room over there first, and I came here the second dive. But this time we're doing the opposite just to do a change. And this is what River of Dreams is used for. I forgot that this song was used for this room. Has been so long since I played this game the first time. And there's a little zoom in the middle. This is where we're gonna find, yep, the pearl. And also we're gonna find these ones. Oh, these are bicolor parrotfish. I did not recognize. They're the younger ones. And this is the pearl of Manaurai, I think, or something like that. Sphere of Manaurai, there we go. This is a treasure you always find there. That's quite an interesting find. This is likely to be the cave's most inner sanctum. Perhaps this is a concealed area that is said to be home to the mermaid's treasure. That is a mermaid's treasure. Then, if the legend is true, which it seems to be because we found the cave the legend talks about, and there's also these pufferfish. Oops, did not mean to grab you. Will you puff? You don't puff. Although it stopped swimming, I wonder if that's a glitch. It literally stopped swimming. It's not moving its fins anymore. Black-spotted pufferfish. This can be seen during the spring around the Blue Hall area. Another off-seasonal fish we can find in this cave. My diver just went invisible. And this is also one of the places in the game where your controls get very finicky when you get into a specific area. I'm going to try to show you what I'm talking about here. I wonder, if you look into that hole, what will you see? It looks like you just see like the open sea from this. Yeah, there's nothing, just the open sea. Although we can't find the outside of this from outside. And there's also, oh, I didn't even pay attention to the dolphin. Hello, there's a dolphin here. It's the false killer whale, I think. I recognize the blackness of it. Where did it go? I lost the dolphin, guys. I'm so good at this. Where did the dolphin go? Ah, there it is. Hello. Do you want to be my friend? Where are you going? Is that what I think it is? A false killer whale? It's very rare for one to be living deep within a cave like this. Try to get to know it. Maybe it'll become a new partner. Your head just went through a wall, dolphin. Do you know that? False killer whale. And this, oh my gosh, my screen is dithering so much. A single specimen can be seen inside the underwater limestone cave between the white areas. Aww, he's probably so lonely. A single specimen in the whole sea. You have no partner. You have no one. You have no friends. You must be so lonely down here. I almost feel bad for him. I should save him from this. If he sees me for his partner, I'm sure gonna accept to get him out of his loneliness. But yeah, the controls get weird in this area I was talking about. It seems like the game used to have something. You see this like sandy area? Look what happens when I go into it. Is it here? I thought it was here. Where is the part where the controls get all weird? There's a specific part where you get like all crazy when you swim. I'm gonna try to find it. Where is it? It might be here. That might have been just it right there, I think. Yeah, look, I'm swimming against a wall, it seems, but there's nothing. It looks like the collision detection is still there for something there used to be there and is not found anywhere else. And look at this. If I zoom to one of these columns here, like just like this, you can see it does this. But if I zoom while I go through this, and it's possible to zoom on air at a specific point, right here, zoom, I get that, a wall. Although if I look at one of the cons directly, it gives me this. And the nearest wall is all the way over here. So it seems like this wall was probably closer in to the room at some point, and they made me decided to make it bigger or something else. I'm not quite sure, but the controls in this area are really weird in that part of the room. And I think that's all that there is to show in this dive. We're already pretty late on time here, so I think it's time to head back to the boat and do the rest of this another day. Put her to your boat?
Yes.
This is going to be a long episode. I'm sorry. But it's quite a lot of exploration to do. Catherine wants to talk to us. Of course, I knew she was going to say something after that. Welcome back and well done. It's hard to believe that a limestone cave as large as that lies submerged in the Manaurai Sea and seemingly identical to the one on the island. In the island, it could be one of the biggest discoveries in recent years. You don't do things by halves, do you? Nope, I do not. I do things fully. Like a boss. And she's gonna talk to us again. Looks like you found an earthenware piece. Can't believe you found an item like this in a limestone cave. You may have stumbled on a very significant object. I'd better let Mr. Tolman see it. He's well known and has friends in the right places. I'm sure he can put us in touch with someone who can help. Cuckoo? You found the sphere of Manaurai. Ooh. It appears to be a metallic, man-made object, yet remains unblemished even after all this time underwater. It's so intricately detailed and virtually flawless in shape. The people of ancient Paul didn't possess ironware or writing, making the origin of this an even greater mystery. Did you know objects of an undetermined origin like this are referred to as ooparts, or out-of-place artifacts? No, I did not know that. It'll definitely make a worthy donation to a museum. Email received. Wow, a lot of things are going on. Let's check the boat first to see if we have anything. Oh, lizard. Hello. Marine iguana. Pretty cool to find that on here. And this is the brown boobies again. Third visit to you birdies. There we go. Anything else? I think that's all on the boat for today. Boobies and one marine iguana. Still pretty good. More fish found, more things in the encyclopedia. Let's look what mail we got. Oh man, we got a lot of emails. Let's look at the first then. Underwater tunnel discovery. From Alfred Tolman. I was startled to hear that you have located a vast underwater cavern. There is a very real possibility that this is the white tunnel spoken of in Paul legends. I am eager to learn more details about your discovery. What is its structure? How deep is it? I am receiving regular updates from Catherine on how the survey is going. Lady Luck smiles on those with the right attitude, and I have been deeply impressed by your positivity and diligence in your work. Rest well, for tomorrow is another day. Green light. This is a legend I was talking about. So it seems you located the white tunnel. I am truly in awe of your underwater skills. With this material, I'll be able to write a great article. Which reminds me, I did some research and it turns out there's more to this legend I told you about before. The only person to escape the tunnel was the queen's handmaid, who followed a mysterious green light and found her way out. A green object. Maybe it is somehow connected to that cave. So if you found yourself lost, you'd do well to remember this legend. And that's what I did with the little fishies that are called green light in Paul. Diving guide request, another one. From Obey Tolman, Global Marine Foundation diving guide organizer. I have received a request from Sofia Marini for a diving guide. She wishes to be guided on a dive in the area around the lagoon. Once you apply to this mail, Mrs. Marini will make her way to your boat. If you choose to accept this job, please respond within the next 7 days. Wishing you luck in all your endeavors. And diving info, Mermaid's Grotto. Mermaid's Grotto, a seemingly ordinary spot. After going through a small tunnel, there's an opening in the rock wall through which one person might fit. This is a place known as Mermaid's Grotto, which no diver has ever entered. It awaits further investigation. A turtle guard? All year round, an ancient turtle swims around the spot, seemingly watching over it. Legend has it that he is guarding the grotto, making sure that it is not disturbed. But perhaps this sounds a little far-fetched. Well, good guardian, I just passed right near him and he didn't do nothing. And that's all the emails that we have. And it is the evening. And this is the perfect time to end this episode. We are here past 40 minutes. Oh man, I really have to end this. Well, that was some pretty good progress. And I'm quite happy about what we did so far in this series. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope that you enjoyed. I really hope that this provided you some enjoyment for today. A smile on your face, a laugh, a chuckle. Something good. Because if I did, I'm happy. And that's all I'm trying to do with this. But anyways, that'll be it for this one. Thank you for watching. And we'll see you in the next episode. MaitreDesBlocs.